Veteran Congress leader and former Union Minister Murali Deora is no more. He passed away early this morning in Mumbai. He was 77 years old. Murali Deora was the Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas in the previous UPA government in 2006. His body will be brought to the Maharashtra State Congress office at noon today, where party workers will be paying their last respects. His cremation is expected to take place at about 4 p.m. Parliament is likely to be adjourned today after paying homage to Deora, who was a sitting Rajya Sabha MP from Mumbai. Let's get an word from our executive editor, Javed Ansari, who's with us in our studios this morning. Javed Ansari, a huge loss for the Congress party.
Yes, indeed it is. Although it must be said that in the last couple of years, owing to his ill health, he was on the sidelines. He wasn't very active. But Murali Deora will be remembered for his genial personality, for his ability to reach out to people, even across the political divide. He was a man with a lot of linkages. He was at a time when America was not the most where there were not too many takers for America in this country. He was a huge advocate of close Indo-American ties. He headed a forum which brought together MPs from the two countries. Murali Deora was instrumental in organizing the plenary centenary celebrations of the Congress party in Mumbai. Extremely close to the Gandhi family, to the Congress leadership, and over the last couple of years, he wasn't keeping well, so he had passed on the mantle to his son, Milan, who lost out in the last Lok Sabha elections.
Right, and Javed Ansari, Murali Deora is also someone who was seen as a grassroots leader. He'd been the mayor also, and someone who shared very good ties not just with the Congress top brass, but also local leaders.
Well, indeed he was. Not only was he close to the Congress leadership, he had linkages with people in the opposition parties. And I know on several occasions, he was extremely popular figure in the Central Hall of Parliament. And you would often see him hosting journalists, as also leaders from the opposition parties. And it was common knowledge that when Murali Deora was the petroleum minister, most opposition leaders, opposition MPs, used to, avoid asking him tough questions. That was the kind of reach he had. That was the kind of rapport he had with people.
Right, Javed Ansari, he was also a very successful businessman apart from being a politician.
Yes, indeed he was. He had very good. He came from that background. He had strong linkages, very good relationship with the corporate world. He helped raise a lot of money for the Congress party's election funds in the years that he was active. And he was known as somebody, who could help build bridges. When the two Ambani brothers were at warhead with each other, or at loggerhead with each other, he was the gentleman which both of them actually used to. He was amongst the few people who had a thing going with both the brothers, and both sides used to refer to him as uncle. And a lot of his political friends in Parliament, I know, used to tease him and call him uncle. And so that was the kind of man that Murali Deora was.
Javed Ansari, stay with us. We also have with us Amrita Shirke, who is with us live from Mumbai. Amrita, we believe that arrangements are being made for a cremation to take place at about 4 p.m. Before that, Mr. Deora's body to be brought to the Maharashtra Sadan, where leaders will be paying their last respects.
Sanjana, I'm standing outside the Deora residence, and you can see behind me the crowd is increasing outside the house of Milind Deora and Murali Deora. People are coming, many relatives are coming, all the MPs and MLAs of Congress, all the grassroots level leaders of Congress are coming here, and the last riots are scheduled at around 4 this afternoon in Chandanwadi. Before that, the body will be kept in Maharashtra Congress office, and the time is around 12 to 2 p.m. The body will be there at outside the office, but now also the crowd is increasing outside the bungalow of Milind Deora and Murali Deora. Milind Deora is inside, rather. He didn't come out to speak to media, but yes, of course, the relatives are coming, all the MPs, MLAs, the grassroots level leaders are coming. It's a great loss, big loss for Congress. Otherwise, the NCP leaders and other the BJP leaders are also expected to come here in some time.
Right, Amrita, I'd like to clarify that something that you've pointed out for us. The body of Murali Deora would be laid out outside the Maharashtra Congress office, where leaders will be paying their last respects. I also want to ask you about Mr. Deora's health over the past few months. He'd reportedly been admitted to a hospital. He'd been battling a long illness.
Sanjana, the death cause is given by doctor, that is the prolonged illness. We all know that his age was 77, and because of that he was hospitalized for last many days, and that is the reason somewhere the family knew that something like this will happen. But definitely, if we talk about the loss, if we talk about the Congress party's loss, it is a big loss for them, because in UPA too, Murali Devra played a very important role for Congress. If we talk about Mumbai, he was born and brought up in Mumbai. He was the he became a mayor of Mumbai in 1977, was the youngest mayor of Mumbai. So definitely he has the connection with Mumbai. After him, his son Milind Devra became the MP from his seat, that was Worli seat, and definitely the connection with Mumbai, the connection with Mumbaikars is there, and because of that many common people are also coming here. But the body will be taken to the Congress office and will be kept there for 12 to 2, and after that the body will be taken to Chandanwadi to perform the last rites at around 4 this afternoon.
Alright, Amrita and Jayan Sai, thanks so much for bringing us the latest on this story. Unfortunate news that the country woke up to, Murali Devra passing away at about 3:45 after battling a long illness.